Today, from my kitchen, I present you a champion of youth coming from Montalcino, Rosso di Montalcino, DOC. So this wine, I like to think that is an excellent wine independently from Big Brother Brunello. It is made with the same Sangiovese grapes coming from the same vineyards located in the same area than Brunello di Montalcino, but has a distinctive personality due to the enhancement of the youth. It might be that I'm getting old, but the more and more I like young wines when they are so succulent and vibrant and also characteristic. This is a wine that was created many, many years ago. It's a way of using grapes coming from younger vines of classified Brunello di Montalcino, and it's only aged for a few months in still in large or medium-sized Slavonian oak barrels. So let's start to have a deeper look at it. The color, I had to wear my sunglasses because it's very brilliant ruby red with medium concentration. Very, very brilliant. The bouquet is delightful. It's a perfect integration of small red berries with hints of mint and eucalyptus. The taste is very silky due to the fact that the tannins are very soft, although very long. The mint, the eucalyptus, and the red berries come back with a touch of licorice. I have to have another sip. This is a wine with long limbs, long and slender limbs, the legs of a ballerina and the wings of swans. Yeah, this is a wine that for me, it's incredibly good to match all sorts of pasta, because the perfect balanced acidity helps to get rid of the excessiveness of starch in the pasta. And expressly pasta as lasagne, or filled pasta, stuffed pasta as ravioli, or fettuccine with cream, it's wonderful. And it's also very, very good with, I would say, white meat, as such as chicken, turkey, or rabbit, or with soft cheeses with a medium sort of concentration in their texture. This is a wine that will keep that aspect of freshness, of mintiness, of slightly herbaceous aspect that characterize the Rosso di Montalcino. And I really am a big fan of it, because I think this wine deserves its own space and doesn't have to be in the shadow of Brunello di Montalcino. It's a wine with incredible class and complexity beyond that sort of simplicity that might appear. And it's also one that can age very well in the bottle for 5, 6, 8, 10 years, no problem. But I really wish you could drink it earlier and buy some more. Cheers.